from the student standpoint, when we talk about teaching and learning as that fundamental core concept, we need to understand that there are some essential values about teaching and learning that we all have to share. And one of the things going forward, and Mike Capel actually led into this presentation in a great way, because I think he was, a lot of his talk was around Carol Dweck's research on beliefs about intelligence and skill set. And he talked about, well, who has talent for art programs, who doesn't have talent for art programs. And he hit on that one comment of strategy being the fundamental operative that everyone leaves out of the equation. Most students who reach a level of frustration at high school or who excel in high school have this feeling that intelligence is something where it's a fixed thing and that it doesn't grow over time, it doesn't change, it's inherently born into you. And all the current research points to the fact that intelligence, in fact, does change over periods of time and people's ability to succeed changes. A lot of students also are under the misconception that effort plus intelligence equals success. And what we really know is that leaves out one of the key component that Mike talked about, and that was strategy. I always use with my students who I see sometimes in my office now, my door opens inward, and I'll say, if I tell you to run headfirst into that door to try and get out the door, you can work as hard as you want, and you're still not going to get out that door and be successful. But if I ask you to use a little different strategy, sometimes you can work half as hard, turn the doorknob, pull the door toward you, and walk right out the door with some success. And so one of the things I want to be working with the teaching staff over the next few years is to develop that understanding of how do we work with students who struggle and how do we work with students who excel so that we're stretching them to that next level and giving them alternate strategies as well as the strategies that they're already comfortable with. So, again, it always comes back to how do we take students where they're at and develop them to that next level where they're able to achieve that. So scholarship, it should be first and foremost. And I think when we talk about connecting with the community, jumping a little bit in terms of order, but the community has to have a level of confidence in Franklin High School moving forward, where Franklin High School, and we throw this term out all the time, that the high school should be the flagship of a district. In many ways, some of the programs that take place at the high school become how a community sees its school system. And I think that the constant communication of high standards and expectations for what we do at Franklin High School has to be paramount to our relationship with the community so that there is a sense of pride in what we do. In terms of leadership style, I guess my goals in terms of leadership would be for a sense of transparency and a sense of inclusiveness in the leadership process. A level of transparency in the leadership process fosters a good, open, and honest communication and starts the beginning of dialogues that need to happen in terms of getting feedback about where the school is at and where the school needs to move forward. Some examples of how to foster a sense of transparency that I've shared with Maureen and I've also shared with Wayne a little bit. One of the things I would like to start is a principal's blog on the school website. I think that newsletters are wonderful ways that we communicate with parents, but I know at the high school level, I always know from my music days that, you know, a parent was reading a newsletter in January congratulating, you know, student X, Y, and Z for their, you know, work on the cross-country team that ended in October. And, you know, we need to have constant communication with parents, and I think a blog is a nice way to have an open dialogue going with the community so that parents have access or community has access to what's happening recently at Franklin High School. So there's one sense of transparency. Also moving forward with the budget, I've talked about maybe some different ideas that I'd like to bounce around. One idea that I have had is doing some podcasts explaining budget requests to the community so that anyone who wants access to information about why the high school has certain requests in the budget process can very quickly go on. Either myself or someone responsible for a program area would be speaking in their own voice about what they think is important and how what they're requesting impacts student learning so that everyone has the same information. It's out in the community and we're just very, very open and clear about where we're coming from and why we ask for things. So I think, again, leadership, that sense of transparency, that sense of inclusiveness, we want to reach out and engage constituent groups in the process of determining a vision for the high school. And I think moving forward, that would be one of my top priorities, especially in the next 6 months. I think looking forward, I'd like to use this next 6 months, one, to take programs that are already either in place or are close to being in place and make sure that those programs get off the ground. And simultaneously, I want to be able to step back from the school a little bit, look at it with a different set of glasses, and take some stock and build a common consensus of vision for the high school, and obviously involve this committee, central office personnel, students, parents, and community members in the process of giving me some data about where do we stand at Franklin High School. So I know I'm going to be sharing an entry plan with Maureen and Wayne, and that certainly will include meetings with a number of constituent groups over the next 6 months to first gather data on my own, and then I also want to be feeding it back to groups like yourself, parents, department heads at the high school, faculty, so that we, not only can we validate the data, but we can also move forward in terms of determining what some of the common threads are that we want to put on our agenda as we head into next year. Finally, I already talked a little bit about ways that we want to connect with the community, that sense of openness and transparency, so that regardless of who wants information about the high school, it's readily available. I met with a Franklin resident and teacher today, along with Ms. Gould, who has been volunteering in the schools. He's a former teacher, and I believe he worked in the Wellesley school system and also in the Wayland school system. And he's been kind enough over the last year and a half now to have come into the high school and worked with some of our teachers, both new and veteran teachers, helping students at the classroom level, and he's volunteered his time to do that. We spoke today about how do we better expand that program and how do we also attract other teachers who have retired, both from the Franklin High School community who may have retired and moved on, but also teachers who may be living in Franklin who worked in other communities who'd like to come into the schools and volunteer some time. I think, you know, this individual spoke about, you know, his passion for teaching and how if you're a teacher, you never lose that passion for working with kids. And this was one way that he could have his free time and yet still connect with kids at that classroom level. And I know from talking with the teachers who he's worked with, he's made a tremendous impact on the teachers as well as with the students he's worked on. And I think that's one great relationship that we can foster and further develop as we move forward. So with that, I'm going to end the presentation. Those are a couple ideas I have. Hopefully they're not the only ideas I have or we're in a lot of trouble.